Good morning, students. So today we are going to continue with the chapter, but before that we are going to revise our previous topic, which is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. So like we have discussed earlier, that flower is the reproductive organ of the plant, which is having different parts, sepals, petals, which are accessory organs, and stamen and pistil are reproductive parts, which have direct role in reproduction. After that, we have discussed that reproduction in flowering plants consists of two levels. One is pollination and second is fertilization. First of all, pollination, which is just the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of a flower. And like we have discussed, pollination is of two types, self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self-pollination occurs only in bisexual flowers, but cross-pollination may occur in both bisexual as well as unisexual flowers. So this is the first step, which is just the transfer of male gamete, just the transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma of a flower. Now, the second step in sexual reproduction in flowering plants is fertilization, which is again of two types. That means there are two fertilizations, and that's why we call this process as double fertilization. So in the first fertilization, that means in the first fusion, one male gamete, which is pollen grain, fuses with the other female gamete, which is egg, and give rise to zygote. And in the second fusion, which is also termed as triple fusion, one male gamete fuses with the two cells of male gametes, or two pollen nuclei of male reproductive organ. Therefore, this is known as triple fusion, because there is a fusion of three cells together, and this fusion leads to the formation of endosperm. So the first fusion, which is syngamy, leads to the formation of zygote, and second fusion, that is triple fusion, leads to the formation of endosperm, which is mainly responsible for providing nourishment to the developing embryo. So after this fertilization, the zygote divides several times and forms the embryo, which then develops into the seed, and the ovary develops into the fruit, and the rest parts of the flower, they may shed off. Only seed and fruit are left, and we all know that seed is the part which is mainly required for the development of new plant or new organism. So that's how reproduction in flowering plants take place. Now we are going to start our next topic, which is reproduction in human beings. And like we all know, reproduction in human beings is only of sexual reproduction. So first of all, let's discuss about male reproductive system. Here is a view of the side view of the male reproductive system, which consists of pair of testes, which produce the male reproductive cells called sperms. And like we have discussed in previous chapter, this is also responsible for secretion of male sex hormone, which is testosterone. So this testes act as a dual gland, which produces hormone as well as sperms, which is male reproductive cells. Now before moving further, let's first discuss about the structure of male gamete, male reproductive cell, which is sperm. So here you can see at the picture, male sperm consists of a long tail. This is midpiece, head, and acrosome. Acrosome is having certain kind of enzymes which help in these sperms to move into the female genital tract or to enter into the egg. And tail helps in movement, and this middle piece is having many mitochondria which help in production of energy, and head consists of the nucleus. So this is what the structure of sperm, which is responsible or which is having the characters of male gamete. Now, coming back to the testes, this testes is the primary sex organ in males, and which is present in a sac-like structure called scrotum. So, aapka jo testes, it is present in a muscular structure called scrotum. This scrotum is having a little bit of less temperature than the body temperature, which helps in the development of sperms. This less temperature is required for the sperms to generate, for active sperms to generate. Now this testis is connected with a long tube called vas deferens, through which movement of sperms take place. This vas deferens is also joined with the more glands. One is seminal vesicle and second is prostate glands. Both of these glands, they provide nutrition as well as help in the movement of the sperms. And this vas deferens, which carries the sperms, it joins with the urethra, which is enclosed in a muscular organ called penis. So this is what the structure of male reproductive system. Now this is female reproductive system. This is the same diagram which is given in your book. This female reproductive system again consists of a pair of ovaries. This is what ovary. This ovary mainly responsible for the secretion of female sex hormone estrogen, which again we have read in previous chapter, as well as for the production of egg, which is female gamete. These two ovaries produce egg alternatively every month. Above the ovaries are the tubes called oviducts or fallopian tube. We may call it fallopian tube or oviduct. Both are having the same purpose. So these two oviducts, they unite into a bag-like structure called uterus. Look at it at the center. This is uterus to which these oviducts are connected. And the uterus has an opening called vagina at the bottom. So this is what the structure of female reproductive system. Ovary, like I told you, produces or secretes a hormone, as well as it produces egg, which is female gamete. This egg travels through the fallopian tube where fertilization takes place. So fertilization of egg or the zygote formation takes place in the oviduct or the fallopian tube only. After the fertilization, that means zygote, it travels into the bag-like structure called uterus, where implantation of zygote takes place. Implantation means it sticks to the wall of uterus and there it starts growing or further division. So this is what the structure of female reproductive system. And this is the structure of human egg, which is spherical in shape and having a nucleus at the center. So this is what female reproductive system, having ovaries, fallopian tube and uterus. Thank you. We'll continue next time.